Hello everybody, welcome to this week's video about bees. I want to talk to you about bees and what they are and what makes a bumblebee a bee and what makes a honeybee a bee, and we'll talk a little bit about solitary bees, and we're going to talk about the life cycle, all bee stuff. It'll be beautiful! Let's start with the parts of a bee. Let's see, I have this magic bag that's going to help me build a bee. So, first I pull out these three different black areas. Oops, let's turn that one around, that makes more sense. And these are the three body parts of a bee. They have an abdomen, they have a thorax, and they have a head. Let's see, this is not looking very bee-like, we need some more things. Aha, legs. Bees are insects, so they have six legs. One, two, three, four, five, six legs. Beautiful. Now their legs attach to their thorax, my friends. They don't have legs on their heads, that would be crazy. And they don't have them on their abdomen, they are on their thorax. Now, let's see what else we have in this bag to make this look much more like a bee. Oh, of course, the classic bee colors. We have these beautiful fuzzy bodies. That goes on the abdomen, and this one goes on the thorax here. And of course, they're yellow and black. Now, bees and wasps have this beautiful yellow-black coloring to tell other animals they are dangerous, because they have that stinger, you know, you have to watch out. Although bees are very kind. Oh yes, bees don't just walk everywhere they go. No, of course they fly, so they have to have wings. They have two wings on each side, two very big ones and two much smaller ones. Perfect, this is starting to look much more like a bee. What else does a bee have? Can you think of anything a bee would have? Let's see. An antenna! Because bees have two antennas on their heads, and that is what helps them feel the world around them. They can smell things through them and feel vibrations, and it helps them a lot. But not only do they have the antennas, but they have big eyes so they can see and spot those beautiful flowers all over. Now the bees will go from flowers to pollinate, and they have these really special things that are on their legs, and they fill them up with pollen, their little sacks, little bags on their legs that they can fill full of pollen. How cool.
Saying it's a bee is very much like saying it's a type of dog. There are lots of different kinds of dogs. Big dogs, small dogs, and same with bees. You can have honeybees, which live in big colonies. A bumblebee, which also live in colonies. There are leafcutter and mason bees. There are digger bees and carpenter bees. And there's also mining bees. And all around the world, there is more than 25,000 different types of bees. That makes one busy bee world.
So my friends, all of these different types of bees are all what we call pollinators. And that means they help the flowers and the plants. So what they'll do is they'll fly to the plants and they will go and then they will get all the pollen both in their sacks on their legs, but they also get them stuck all over their very fuzzy bodies. And that's why they have such fuzzy bodies. And then they'll fly away, they'll go to another plant. And when they go to that plant, then they leave a bunch of that pollen on that plant, which can help that plant make seeds. And that's how plants are able to create more seeds. But they must have these birds and bumblebees and other different types of pollinators, and bees are one of the most important ones. The plants, they need the bees to help them grow. Now, my friends, even my small insect friends are being very safe in these troubled times. Make sure you're keeping your distance and you're staying very far away from all your friends. Stay safe, everybody. My friends, thank you so much for joining me this week. Calgary is a bee city, which means that we have lots of different habitats for bees to live in. Lots of different flowers for them to go and visit, and lots of different types of bees in Calgary. So when you're in your own backyard or in your neighborhood park, keep a close eye watch for bumblebees and other types of bees that live here in Calgary. Have a wonderful week, everybody.